decided to kind of play around with an eye look that I would do if I were gonna be going to prom or grad in 2017. I remember when I graduated, I didn't want my makeup to be overly heavy because at that time I wasn't one that really wore a lot of makeup, but I definitely wanted to do something that was unique. I remember I asked my makeup artist to do a double winged eyeliner, which was not too heavy on the eye, but it was something unique. And it was something special for grad. So the look I did today was a half cut crease, which brightens the inner corner. Then I did a floating silver eyeliner. I feel like those two things are very popular right now, and they're not the most unique, but when you put them together, it is a really pretty look for grad. It's not too heavy on my eye, but it still is really pretty. I know a lot of people for grad and prom want to do something with their makeup, but sometimes just a boring, neutral, smoky eye is just too boring. But this is kind of play on that with a little bit more going on. By the way, aside from YouTube, I do post on Instagram. I actually have two accounts. I have one, which is Angel and Versace, which is like my personal, but also not my personal. I post makeup and fashion and all that kind of stuff on there. And then I have a second account called Alexi Artistry, and that's where I mainly will post all of my makeup looks. And I'll do 3 posts in one day, just showing different features of that makeup. So if you do want to see more of me, then you should follow both those accounts. So if you're interested in seeing how to achieve this look, then just continue on watching. I've already primed my lids with my Smashbox 24-hour photo finish primer, and then I put a bit of the Tarte Shape Tape on just to conceal any of the veins. I think I'm gonna try doing that floating liner look where you put some tape a little bit higher than where you would actually wanna stop your eyeshadow, and then it looks like that part of the shadow is floating. We'll see, we'll try it out. The reason I cut the strip thinner is that's when I put it on my eye, it doesn't go over my eyelashes and cause my eyes to close. I also cut the piece of tape that's closest to the inner corner of my eye at a slant so that it will sit flat. So for the entire eye look, I'm gonna be using the Morphe 35F palette. For my transition shade, I'm just gonna go into this lightest peach shade right at the end. I'm just gonna jump over one color into this shade right over here. It's like a camel brown. So the next shade I'm going into is this shade right over here. I'd say it's like a shade or two darker than the camel shade I just went in with. I'm still gonna use this brush, and then I'm gonna switch to a smaller brush using the same color just to give it a gradient effect. So now I'm gonna go in with my MAC 217 brush, and this is a lot smaller than the previous brush. It's a little bit more dense, but it still will blend it out, and I'm gonna go in with the exact same color. Darker red shade to add some definition. I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M506 brush. This is a really small buffing brush, but what I'm gonna do with this is I'm gonna put it in the outer corner and then buff it into the crease, but stopping halfway. So I didn't realize that my camera turned off, but I just finished off by pulling the tape off, and then I took a little makeup wipe and just tried to clean as close as I could up to that line, because I did have primer on and obviously a bit of the primer is still sticking on. So I just cleaned off a bit of the concealer, but I'm gonna go back and clean it up with more concealer, so it's okay if it looks a little messy right now. Now I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape concealer, and I'm going to cut my inner crease, but I'm only gonna do a half cut crease. So I'm gonna take this a little bit higher than my natural crease so that when I close my eyes, you can still see that I've cut the crease. So now that I've cut that crease, I'm just gonna go in to my Tarte Pro palette, and I'm just gonna pop into the shade Vintage, which is the creamy white shade, and I'm just going to set this cut crease. So now that I have both of the cut creases done and set, I'm gonna go into the darker red shade with a Morphe E18 brush. So this is a very small, it's not a pencil brush, it's a little bit bigger than a pencil brush, but it really buffs in the color, so I can make sure that it has a nice gradient and that this corner where the cut crease and then the eyeshadow connect, there isn't a obvious line there. But I wanna make sure that I don't place this color at all underneath this wing that we have. I'm gonna stop with the eyes, and I'm gonna go back and add a little bit more more stuff in afterwards, but I'm just gonna complete my face and then come back to that. I'm just gonna prep my skin with the Farsali Rose Gold Elixir. I recently picked this up during the VIB sale and I absolutely love it. I talked about it in my last video. I find that my foundation really glides on so nicely when I have this on. Previously, it didn't look bad, my foundation, but I just feel like this brought this up to the next level. For foundation, I'm going with my Makeup Forever Ultra HD Foundation Stick. When you're a member, go on your great adventure again. We'll be waiting. For concealer, I'm going in with my Tarte Shape Tape, and this is where I'm going to want to clean up this edge. So I'm actually going to clean that up first, and then I'm going to go in for my under eye concealer. But I'm going to go in with this same brush I used to cut my crease. And then I'm just going to blend it out with my damp sponge. So my eyes look like they were creasing really quickly after I put on my concealer. So quickly, I just set them off camera. But I'm going to go in with my Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Powder Foundation and set the rest of my face. Bronzer, I'm going in with my Benefit Hoola Light. I'm going in with the Too Faced blush. It is called Baby Love. So I just want to sharpen my bronzer. So I'm going to take my powder foundation and a sponge, and then I'm just going to dab it in the powder. I'm just going to swipe it. So I'm going to go in with my Cocoa Lashes in Queen Bee. I cut them in half so they're not as big and they don't overtake my eyes as much. And then they're more of like an outer corner lash. So now that I have my lashes on, I'm going to go in with a bit of color on my bottom lash line. I'm going to use the exact same colors in the exact same order. So now that I finished off the eyes, I'm going to go in with the NYX Liquid Crystal Liner in Silver. And I'm going to put this right underneath that wing and basically just outline that wing so that it's a little bit more obvious and that there's just a little bit more going on with the look. I'm gonna have to get really close to the mirror with this, so I'm probably gonna go out of focus, but I'm gonna try not to. Be a part of the love club. Everything will glow for you. For highlighter, I'm gonna go into the Nicole Girl Glow Kit, and I'm gonna go into the shade Forever Lit and Kitty Cat Mixed. For the love club. I think this is a perfect look for prom and grad because it's not just that normal neutral smoky eye or that warm tone smoky eye. It is still light on the eye and it doesn't overtake your face, but it has a little bit going on with the floating silver liner and then the half cut crease, which really brightens that inner corner of your eye and opens up your eyes and make it look bigger. If you did like this video, I would love if you could like, subscribe, and comment down below.